Hey guys, Michael Reed here from Glowbox 3D. We're going to go through another Blender 2.9 Plus tutorial. And in this one, we're going to go through the process of taking a mesh model from Blender, exporting it on over to Substance Painter, doing a little magic on it there, baking those textures out and putting them back on a model in Blender. Yeah, and one of the things we're going to do here is a little trickeroony, is we're going to start with a little diffuse here, a diffuse, and we're going to import that into Substance Painter as kind of a base. That's one of the tricky questions sometimes people ask, is how do I start with my old model's texture from Blender? Anyway, that's the process we're going to go through in an under 10 minute tutorial, so thanks a lot. And I didn't go to Duke. All right guys, here we are in Blender, and our model in question here is a little soda dispenser I made the other day, and we've left the diffuse albedo channel on there, which we're going to import into Substance Painter and use as our base texture here. And quickly we're going to jump over to UV Editor, and you're going to see that we do have a UV channel here, and it is only one channel here that we're going to be doing, because if you work in Substance Painter, sometimes if you have things broken up in multiple channels, this will be reading as multiple UVs in Substance, but this is a joined object, all in one UV, starting from there. All right, and quickly, you're gonna see here, one of the things we're gonna start with before we export is we're gonna make sure our model here is selected, and we're gonna Control A, and we're gonna do all transforms, and that's gonna put our world origin down here at the base, and the scale, and it's gonna work all that ready for export. Go up here to File, Export, FBX. We're gonna do selected objects. We already have it here, soda dispenser, and that is great, and everything else default here is just fine. So go ahead and do that. And now we're gonna jump on over to Substance Painter here, and we're going to go new, and we're gonna select here, and we're gonna select our object right there. And we're gonna do a 2K for this. I did 4K originally. Actually, let's just do 4K just for fun. And here we go. And we've got our model here in question. The first thing you want to do, we're just going to quickly do it, is go to texture set settings. We're going to go to bake mesh maps. We're going to go to 4K and we're going to bake those out. And it's going to bake all the curvatures and the world ID, the ambient occlusion, all this fun stuff that Substance Painter likes to work with. Just so we can get a little starter on our shape, and Substance Designer sort of understands the shape and mesh and curves of our model. Okay, there we go there. And we're gonna go now into textures and import here, this little button here. We are going to import, and we're gonna add a resource, and we are going to navigate to our soda dispenser and PBRs here. And we're going to go with this here, one right here, right? Select that, which is a diffuse from Blender. We're gonna select it as a texture. We're gonna go into this project here, whichever you name it. We're gonna import that, and it's gonna put it right down here, okay? Now, what we wanna do here is, just so you know, back up, you can see that this is our UV channel and only one UV material ID, basically. And from here, we're gonna go back into layers. We're gonna do a fill layer here, this bucket right here. And the fill layer here, we're gonna get rid of height, roughness, metal, and normal, so we're stuck with color. And the magic happens when you take your imported diffuse from Blender, drop it on the base color there, and look at that, the magic of technology. So from here, we're going to look at this and go, oh, that's great, this is fantastic. I just wanna add a few more things to this. So we're gonna go add another fill layer, and we're gonna go down to Smart Masks. This is not a Substance Painter tutorial. We're just gonna add a quick little bunch of, you know, PBR textures so that we can do the exporting over, just to illustrate that point. Go to Smart Masks here, and let's just say we're gonna do a, dirt splashes. We're gonna drag that onto Fill Layer there. Ooh, that is very pretty. Right, that is super pretty. We're going to actually select the color here. Being facetious. And I'm gonna go down here and I'm gonna make it just like dirtier like that. And then we're going to just lessen it a little here and go, all right, that's fine, whatever. And then you know what we're gonna do here? We're gonna add another one real quick here, just so you can see, a smart mat, another fill layer. And we're gonna go to, we're gonna go to dirt cavities. We're gonna drop dirt cavities on there. And that is going to create these little, you can see, little things there. And we're going to actually make that dark as well. All right, now that we've got, Substance Painter has already basically created all the PBR situations for this by just doing basic work here. It probably would anyway from the beginning. What we're going to do here is export to textures, export these. We're going to select our file in question. Let's go to soda dispenser, PBR here, and we're going to, for our test, we're going to go toot, and this is a PBR toot tutorial. And we're going to select that, and it's automatically going to make it 4K because that's how we had it here. And, you know, you can go through these things and do what you want in terms of setting it up for Unreal Engine, setting it up for any, I mean, Substance Painter has exports galore of your choices, but we've got ours set up basically for a standard metal roughness PBR. We're going to export that right there. And boom, those 4K textures are done. We're gonna go back into Blender here. We're gonna go into shading mode, and you can see we just have our you know, sad little lonely diffuse here. You know, just for fun, we're gonna delete that. Just delete it, we don't even need it anymore. And we're gonna select the, of course, guys and gals, all right? If you don't have Node Wrangler running on Blender, if you don't go in and add it on right away, then I don't know what I can do to help you going forward. Anyway, so we're going to go to add-ons here, and we're going to make sure that N-O-D-E, Node Wrangler, is clicked on. Okay, good. Nice. Moving on. We're going to select the principal BSDF here. We're going to do Control-Shift-T, and that's going to pull up Node Wrangler's you know, window here. We're going to go to PBR, the Toots folder we did, and now look at this. Substance Painter has created all of these now for it. Right, and we're going to select that, and it is going to connect it, and you can see all of our wonderful stuff that we did in Substance Painter is on there in a full PBR set. And there you go, guys. And now from here, if I were to take this full information now with all the PBRs on it, and I were to export that as an FBX again, a lot of programs will read those textures. They will take the textures and they will say, hey, thanks for this whole PBR set on the model. I've got it in the FBX. All right, guys, now that's been an under 10 minute tutorial here on the process of exporting and importing from Blender to Substance Painter. Hope you had a great day. All right, take care.